Let's see.
Let's get ready to rumble.
All right, y'all. These are four statements that a group leader gave that's very ineffective to help deal with a client that was not, let's say, acting appropriately in group. If you just take one and reformulate that into a better statement that addresses that you are confronting the client, but it is a more therapeutic statement, that's your assignment. And you have 2 minutes to come up with a statement. Uh-oh, did I turn it off? Oh. Go ahead, what about you? Deal with that confrontation, come on. Does anybody want to share what they wrote as far as giving a more effective response?
I can share. Okay, so number one, you're always giving everyone advice. I wish you would just focus on yourself. I would remind them of the meta theme of counseling and say, look, our job is not to tell people what to do. Maybe not in that, it would be cloaked. Remember what we're trying to do here. We're not saying do this or that. What we're trying to do is uncover the faulty thinking and reasoning that we're going through. So we don't want to go forward to what you should do. Let's take a step backwards and try to see what's in the machine that's producing these. So, yeah.
So in reminding them of why they're here and the work that needs to get done.
Right.
Okay. Anyone else? Betty, are you okay driving? You're scaring me. Okay.
So I'm fine. I'm looking straight ahead.
Okay. Anyone else? Oh, come on.
I wrote in the chat for number two, hey, blank, I've noticed you haven't shared with the group. However, you appear to be engaged. How might sharing with your peers improve your experience in group?
So a more open-ended question, right? To an open-ended question to really deal with that, the problematic behavior that's going on in group, right? These are really good examples of how to use confrontation in not what we think of, right? Let's get ready to rumble or getting ready for a boxing match. It doesn't have to be that. right? And if you are able to reframe, you know, what we traditionally think of confrontation as, you think you're gonna, that's not what happens in group. And if you're able to practice this in your everyday life, like if you're on the phone with customer service and they're, you know, being a little not customer servicey, you're practice those skills of acknowledging what's going on and let's talk about it. That sort of thing. Anyone else want to share one more before we go? Come on, one more.
The screaming fists were disturbing.
What was that? Me?
No, the picture of your screaming fists that you had in the presentation.
Oh, isn't that weird?
That was disturbing. That was freaking out, man.
I saw that.
I agree. I was looking at my own fists, like, imagining faces on them. It was weird.
I actually love that.
Oh, yes.
That's some good photoshopping there. I wish I could take credit for it, but not me.
It looks like Trump on the right.
Yeah. So again, and I hope what you've gotten out of some of this is that confrontation is very necessary. It can be very therapeutic, and it can also really sharpen your skills as a counselor, because many times, again, we are conditioned to shy away from conflict and just avoid it ourselves. And so now we're put into a situation where not only do we need to encourage it, but we need to be able to manage and navigate it too. But once you see the therapeutic value of it, it will just encourage you to do it more and more. And it won't be just, again, in your therapeutic world. It will be in your personal life too, and vice versa, that sort of thing. All right. Any questions?
I have a question.
Sure.
So we're talking about conflict, and it's one thing for two members to have a conflict, because then you as the leader can be like a referee. But what if the member, or what if more than one member is having conflict with the counselor, like open conflict during the session?
Well, again, I'm going to bring it back to the four agreements, right? We're not going to take it personally, and we're not going to make assumptions. So we're not taking that. They're not having an issue with me, Patricia. They might be having an issue with something else. And so that's what I have to work on with them. So you're bored in the group. Tell me more about what you would like to see in the group, right? Because it's their responsibility to do the work. Right. And if they're upset with me about something that I either did or didn't do, then we can have that conversation. Let's talk about observable behaviors. Well, when this person said this, you didn't do that. OK, I see your point. Let's talk about that some more. But I'm not taking it personally, because I can't manage everything all of the time. I can't be perfect every time I'm in that group. Right. And so there will be those times when, you know what, I had a little bit of a brain fart. I was, you know, thinking about lunch or whatever. And I miss that. And the beauty of group is that you can always go back and revisit that. You know, so-and-so brought this to my attention that last week when this conversation was had, that I missed it. And when he brought it to my attention, and when I reflected back on it, he was right that I did miss that. And so I would like to revisit that. But that's important that you, again, don't take things personally and don't assume, right? Let's ask those clarifying questions. Well, what exactly are you referring to? And many times I would always ask my clients to, when they would say, oh, that person's such a jerk, and that's not the word they used, right? I'd say, just, well, what do you mean by that? Give me some behaviors. And they'd look at me like, you don't know what a jerk is? No, because my definition of a jerk, it might be different than your definition of a jerk. So I want to know what the behaviors are so we can actually talk about the behaviors. And so now they had to think about, well, why are they? Well, what makes them a jerk? And then all of a sudden it was like, oh, wait a minute, I do some of that too, right? And so it was definitely some insight when, you know, it's so easy to go and point the finger at someone else, but then when you describe the behaviors, it's like, well, do you engage in that behavior, those behaviors too? So it's, confrontation can be very therapeutic, as long as, again, you are mindful of your own emotions